Hello, 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 and welcome back to Vampyr. In the last part, we got tasked by Lord Redgrave to find out the source of this influx of skull and Spanish flu, how it, you know, works together, how it correlates. Oh, God. That's a huge werewolf. We also made sure to kill some more citizens in Whitechapel. Ow, my body. That hurt. Stop it. All of you, stop it. Look at my blood. Look what you guys did. I really should have upped that some more instead of just my health and my stamina. But that's really all I care about, which is terrible. And that resulted in me killing... Who did I kill? I killed the prostitute and the journalist. That resulted in, like, everybody getting sick all over the place. So, before I started recording, I ran around and I healed everybody. Am I going the wrong way? Hang on, guys. I'm going the wrong way. I don't care what you're doing. No, no. Go ahead. You guys try and break into that person's place. But in the last part, we also took care of a side quest for Lady Ashbury's daughter. And if I have time and if I remember, I would really, really, really like to see if I can get back to her house. I don't remember exactly where it is, obviously, because I just rely on waypoints to get me everywhere. But I know this is the way we went to get to her house, and we fought a vampire outside of her house. But yeah, for the life of me, I can't remember exactly where it is. Hi, guys. You're really low level. That's nice for me. I don't get that very often. I wish I could remember where her house was. It's a very nice house. I want to say it was that huge one down there, but that doesn't seem right. Hi. Look at you, big guy. Hey, friend. Cute. Cutie pie. Now you're dead. Yeah, the really dramatic death these guys have. Wish it would tell me or, like, put a waypoint so I would know, like, where particular things are. Hi. Finsbury Theater. Okay. I don't remember seeing a theater. Man, I have absolutely no recollection of where her house is. I'll probably have to look it up. Oh, you guys are so annoying. And then I gotta fight the vampires, too, which is equally annoying. Because they should be my friends, because we're all vampires here. Is this it? Is this her house? I don't know how I found it. I got all turned around.
Elizabeth doesn't seem to be at home. I'll come back later.
Alright, whatever. Then I don't get to go to her house. Anyway, let's just go on with the quest. We're gonna... There's two different places where that might be the source of infection after we asked a bunch of townspeople where it might be. So we're gonna go check out those two places, whichever one I come across first, because that's how I roll, baby. Ooh, I got a loading screen because I'm running into the West End. Is that why? It's done that a few times and it's super weird to me. Don't like it at all. Alright, this is locked up, so I can't get in there. That's fun. I'm gonna kill you. Just let me figure out how to get to these places and it'll be all good. Stop making everything so confusing. I mean, I'm not a fan of the way these parts of the city are mapped out at all. Not a fan. Do not recommend.
That building is under quarantine. Could this be what I'm looking for?
Oh, it could be, but the door's locked. Just like I can't get over to Dorothy, even though I try every time I go, you know, the poor nurse I turned into a skull by accident. I always try and get over there, but I just can't. Can't figure it out. All right, there's Lady Ashbury's daughter. There's our friend, so that's fine. Let's try and skirt around the long way, see if we can get there. All right, this is open. Or pass through a bowl. It never seems to get any closer. okay. Let's get up here then. Yep. And from here, nowhere. This does nothing for me. Why is this here? I'm just going around in freaking circles. Okay, some more scaffolding. Ken, I don't know if this will help me. Because this door is locked.
I cannot enter.
Everything's locked. So what do you want for- Whoop, whoop. got Jonathan stuck there for a second. What do you want from me, Jonathan? Just tell me what you want and I'll do it. I'm here to please. The Ichor's Threat, new collectible. Okay, it was on the body of a dead vampire. Of all the evil and foul skulls I ever had to fight, the Ichor, or Ichor, may be the worst. Not because of its fighting prowess, even if it remains a powerful and dangerous opponent, not because of its superior wit or cunning plans. An Ichor is quite blunt and straightforward in his actions and objectives, spread diseases, contagions, and epidemics whenever and wherever it can. This is like a skull to them. An Ichor is the incarnation of viruses and infections. Wherever it goes, sicknesses appear and quickly spread. It is like it only walks this earth to generate plagues and epidemics, as if its skin itself diffuses sickness. Yeah, Yeah, I know. I've fought a few skulls that exploded into green gases. Ikors are clever, sneaky, malevolent, and ferocious, capable of enduring many wounds. To spoil a water tank, a granary, or a banquet, this is the kind of things. I don't know who wrote this. It's either these are the kind of things, or this is the kind of thing. Choose, plural or singular. I have such a stickler for grammar. An Ikor would enjoy to do in order to please its putrid and perverse nature. They are so rare that we do not know anything about them. The Lazy Brotherhood believes that they should not be considered vampires or skulls, but as something else. All I know is this, an Ikor must be destroyed by all means necessary as soon as it is spotted from Know Your Enemies by Carl Eldritch, Prewin Leader. Yup. Doesn't help me at all, though. Just good to know. All right. I'm gonna give up on this one, and let's try and go to the one farther off and see if that door's locked, just to make me miserable. So that seems to be the goal, is to make me miserable. All right, maybe I found a way around it. All right, I'm guessing these are one of the skulls that explode. No, get out of the way. Ugh, disgusting. Ran across quite a few of those. Ran across, can't talk. Okay, aha, there we go. Finally, I'm in the building of the place, I think, that Jonathan wants to check out. So let's first, of course, steal all their stuff, since there's obviously nobody here. Yes, I will leave there in 1 second. Let me just check. More stuff is always required. Ooh, this door looks weird. And it says something on it, but I can't read it. All right, open this door. Do I dare? Get down on the ground. Oh, there's another explodey gal from all the sores on her. Oh, I don't remember her name. The woman who the sewer skulls rescued. I bet that's what she is, one of those. She's gonna explode into horrible gas and kill them all, and it won't matter anyway. Okay, this is gonna be it. This is the one. Money. Cleanse the second source of infection, reach the first source of infection. Well, I didn't know which one was which. I probably should have just checked. I just wanted to get to whichever one was closest. Priscilla McPherson, admit it, you cheap bastard. We can't hear her. And I'm not rushing over to her anyway. What's this? Oh, remarkable pump action shotgun. That does sound remarkable, Jonathan. Oh, that's quite lovely. It's quite great. I don't use the guns, but I might. If I come across a particularly difficult boss. Okay. What am I looking for? Can I pop over there? Why can't you just pop up here? I don't get it. What am I missing? A sign? No? I don't want that. Go. How do I cleanse an infection? Oh my god! Why do this? Let me pop up the stairs! Let me get up the stairs! Why can't I? I don't understand. Alright, I'm gonna have to leave and see if there's a different entrance, because this is poo. This is absolutely ridiculous. Is there anywhere for me to pop up somewhere? Because I can hear them fighting, but they can't do anything. Let's go down here. We're on the other side of the gate anyway. Is there another door I'm missing? Or blood? There's a skull. One of these. What the hell? Why can't I kill this thing? I don't remember how to switch to my, my other weapons. Hang on. How do I switch them? Oops! Wrong button. Oops! She got me. She done got me. God damn it, just freaking... No, I'm gonna have to use a ranged weapon. I just don't remember how to switch to him. Right, shoot her! No! Aim at her and shoot her. There we go. How do I load my gun? Excellent. What a horrible woman. Okay, there's no other place that I can see. There's no other door that I can see. This is it. This is the one. So how does one get around this issue? Because they're obviously upstairs. So what do I do? Okay, so I just looked it up. My game is totally bugging out. It's supposed to give me the option to pop up there. So my game is bugging out, which I figured is what it was supposed to do, but it's not. I don't have the option to pop up there, which makes this impossible. And I don't know if that means it's because I have to do the first infection first. That's the only thing that I can think of. So I'm gonna leave this horrible place. Can I unlock the gate from here? That would be fantastic. I can. Okay, that'll make it so much easier. I'm gonna do that first and see if that makes things possible for me. I don't know. But I think that's quite unfair, to be perfectly honest.
Why are vampire hunters sniffing around?
I don't know, Jonathan.
I need to find out what they're up to.
Yeah, that's exactly what we need to do. First, we gotta kill them. And that... I don't know if I need blood, but I'm taking some anyway. No, no. Yes, Jonathan. We know. I don't have to brag about it all the time. Nope, this isn't a boarded up place. Ah, this might be. This might be the one. Okay.
This woman's body has multiple lacerations. They're deep, too. Whoever did this was driven by rage.
Okay. Whoa, that's a lot of blood. Good lord. Poor woman. You steal all your stuff. You won't mind now that you're dead. Where's the blood leak? All down the hallway. All right, check that out in a minute. Oof. That guy.
He had his tongue removed and his eyes gouged out. He was a victim of brutal torture.
What the hell happened? Who's doing that? The guard of Prewin guys? Because I think there's some downstairs. Or they might be outside, but I think they're downstairs. Blood everywhere. Whoop.
This one's neck is broken. He was young. Probably the son.
That's horrible. As someone who fell down the stairs recently in my apartment building, that is horrible. That's the exact thing I was afraid of as I was falling. Only thing I was focused on was keeping my head from bouncing off the stairwell and breaking my own neck. This one's alive. This one's alive. It's alive. It's a skull, though, for sure. Yeah. Harriet. Harriet was her name.
You thought I was dead too, didn't you?
Liza, my lady!
No, I was just pretending. Doris told me I could have been a great actress.
You killed your family.
Obviously.
They mocked my talent.
Right. Right, okay. Can I hit you or are you gonna freak out like the other ones? I don't care. I don't care if that's what you do. Let's do this thing. Yeah, let's do that. It's always fun. If you get him trapped in a corner, there's not too much they can do about it.
Seen such a radical mutation.
Oh, God.
Could it be a new stage in the disease's evolution?
Yeah, it looks exactly like Harriet looked, who we already met, and we already saw what she looked like. She was all covered with those boils, too. It's not a great revelation, my dear. Letter from the Fletcher Acting School, Dear Elsa. I thought her name was Eliza. It said Eliza. Whatever. Maybe she used a stage name. It's with the greatest joy that I confirm with this letter your acceptance as a private student into my acting school. The little scene you had the kindness to perform for me last week convinced me that you have what it takes to be a real actress. Wits, stature, and courage. I don't know why I'm having trouble reading. As a private student, you'll receive my personal training and coaching. During these intense sessions, you'll be invited to stay at the school since I strongly believe in total immersion to explore the full potential of my students. So please remember to bring night attire and anything you may need to spend a week at my school. Yours sincerely, Doris Fletcher.
So, this girl took lessons at the famous Doris Fletcher.
Is it famous?
School.
I'll take your word for it. Okay. Now I wonder. First, I'm going to explore the house a little bit more. If I head back to the second infection, if I can pop up the stairs now. Okay, fan-dabby-dozy. Blood everywhere. Let's go. I was like, who's knocking? It was just a priest. Are you someone I know or someone I don't know? No, you're the one who's crazy. And you think about rats all the time. I remember you. You were fun. All right, come on now. Please. Please let it not be bugged out. Please allow me to proceed with the game. No, I can't. Well, that's fantastic. Why not? All right, I restarted my game, restarted the PlayStation, and look, it's here. Oh my god, can you believe it? So annoying. Only me, right? Only. Can I just kill you both? All right, good. This is so gross. Just missed a whole bunch and just wasting blood all over the place. I mean, they're not that much stronger than me. I just want them to die a lot. Just give me more blood. Use it. Yeah. Take him out. Take him out. You caused me so much freaking problems, guy. Thank goodness. Annoying. Annoying you are. Is it over? Can I leave this horrible place and go back to that other horrible place? Gather information. What information do you want me to gather? I killed him. Don't do this. Don't be so buggy. There we go. Okay. Love. Oh, it's from another Doris. Or the same Doris, rather. Love letter. Darling, thank you for the precious perfume and the fur coat. I can't wait to feel your hands on my shivering skin. For only you, my hero, can make me feel that desired. Please come back to me soon, for I'm dying to press my timid bosom to your chest again. Bosom. Yes, my beloved, my precious, come back to me, and I promise you a night of eternal and unbridled passion. Right now, I'm wearing nothing but your last gifts. Oh, yes, I'm burning for you, and I can't wait for you to share my untamable lust. You're devoted.
So the
Doris
husband
Fletcher
had an affair with Doris Fletcher.
Oh my. An affair. So silly. Locate Doris Fletcher's theater. I think I found it actually the other when I was running around.
Doris Fletcher seems to be the missing link here. It can't just be a coincidence.
No. No such thing as
a coincidence.
I should
go to her acting school.
I want to be an actor, Jonathan. Oh, we can actually go and talk to Lady Ashbury now. That's pretty sweet. I'm actually, like, honestly, like, quite annoyed at the moment. It was so hard for me just to finish that quest. Whose room is this? Where'd I get a key from? What's this? Aubrey Reed's first letter, like ever? Reed Mansion, 4th April, 1908. My dear and beloved John, when you receive this letter, you'll be 35 and I'll be long gone. I feel a little silly writing you this first letter that you won't read for a few years. I struggled for a long time about how best to write you this until I remembered the puzzle and riddles I invented for you when you were a boy. Oh, how I loved to solve those enigmas. Well, I found it would be a good idea to propose to you one final game. It will probably be less rewarding, no candies or exotic treasures for you if you decipher the game this time. But a greater treasure, perhaps, the truth. This is my only attempt for you to explain why I chose to leave my family without an explanation. If you want to know why, simply play my little game. It's really up to you, my son. Rest assured that I love you, even if I can't spell. I promise my family was and still is everything to me. I remember the first time I held you and your sister in my arms, my treasures, my jewels. See you grow up, play, and laugh filled my heart with joy every time I went back to our home. I could have killed to protect you, my son, my daughter, my wife, but fate found me in the end. I had to make a tough decision. The worst was to disappear without a word. I decided to do it anyway, and soon I'll be gone for good. I don't ask for forgiveness, but for understanding. If you want to know more, all you have to do is remember how happy we were back in those days. This is not a puzzle. If you want to find the next message, think green grass and tall trees on sunny Sundays. From your affectionate father, Aubrey Reed.
I remember Sunday walks in the park.
A journey to the past. Oh, that's definitely something we'll have to take care of. That's awesome. I love me some riddles. What else can we find is obviously your mom wandering around the hallways going, Mary? Mary, where are you? Don't talk to her. She's got flowers in front of the door. It must have been Mary's room. And this must be her room. Okay. We can't go in it for some reason. All right. I'm gonna sleep because I'm annoyed. And I don't think I have enough to level anything up, so it doesn't really matter. Unless I can level up my blood some more, which would be nice. I can. Yeah, I could do that a couple of times. That's enough. It doesn't get me a higher level, but... Or did it? It might have. One higher than I was. That's fine. And we'll see how the district is doing. All right, nothing changed. Everybody's stable in West End. But Whitechapel. I did go through and heal everyone. Who else is sick? I can't move my screen. Ooh, look, we went way up. I done did good. All right, Father, FR stands for Father? Tobias Whitaker or Friar? Not really sure. Gotta heal him, but I don't really care about that because I'm gonna kill him as soon as I hit Mesmerize level 5. And everybody in Pembroke, come on, bring us back to healthy. Just got a couple of people who are still sick. Our actions have impacted the borough's economy. Why? Because I killed one person? Doesn't seem quite fair. All right, so I can definitely go back and heal all those people up. And there was no one sick in the docks, and there's still no one sick in the docks, so I don't know. I really don't know what to do about all that. But like I said, I'm going to end this part here. In the next part, I will just like I did before, I'll run before I record, heal anybody who's sick, then we'll talk to Lady Ashbury, and then we'll go find this Doris Fletcher person in her acting school and see what the connection is to all this. But if you did enjoy, please let me know in the comments, leave me a like or a dislike, and of course you can subscribe if you want to, and I'll see you for the next part of Vampyr. Bye bye!